Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm going to show you in this video a project that I made last weekend. So it took me like probably a day and a half, where I got challenged by some guys on the internet to make a computer and Sinclair Spectrum on an FPGA. So basically what I did, I downloaded a Z80 implementation from OpenCourse. I simulated, it worked fine, so I was happy. Then I attached some block RAM, which I initialized with a few assembly, I just put some simple operations in and out to see if it executing from memory, and it did. And then I started to learn a little bit about Sinclair Spectrum. I was a Commodore 64 guy. I was kind of in the opposite camp. So I didn't know much about Spectrum other than it had a horrible keyboard and very difficult to type with those fancy, keys. So I started to learn a little bit about how the Spectrum works, and I downloaded the original ROM, the basic interpreter. So I wrote a Python script to initialize the block RAM memory with the original ROM. And obviously I had to display on something, so I had to understand how the video memory works. And there's loads of information on the internet. So I wrote a small timing controller for VGA. So I'm displaying everything on 1024 pixels on horizontal and 768 pixels on vertical, which is four times the resolution of the original Spectrum. And the timing, the VGA, it's a VGA mode. The timing generator, I actually designed it with ChatGPT a while back. I have a video about that. I'll link it in the description. And I bolted everything together. Initially, I didn't have a keyboard, so I had some buttons on the board, and I was pressing those buttons, and I was getting some funny characters. But then I attached a PS2 keyboard, and I had to write a layer of to adapt to be presented as a scan matrix keyboard like the original Spectrum has. And it took me a while to make this adaptation between the scan codes from a PS2 keyboard into scanning codes for the Spectrum. But then I realized that I have only one PS2 keyboard, and it was kind of dodgy. So I downloaded again a very good implementation in Verilog for attaching a USB low speed keyboard. And I instantiated in VHDL, so I went mixed language there, and it worked. So I think across a day and a half, maybe 2 days of coding, I got this Spectrum working nicely, color on a monitor. Now, an interesting fact is that I'm running the Z80 at 65 megahertz. You may wonder why 65 megahertz, from where this number comes. It's actually, that's a pixel clock for the video side, and for that resolution, 1024x768 at 60 hertz. So I said, I'm going to run everything with one clock. But I made some experiments. I can run the Z80 probably with 80 megahertz, 85-ish. So anyway, I have a Sinclair Spectrum which runs at 80, at 65 megahertz, which is not exactly practical because it's way too fast. But it works, and I'll show you how it works. Now, I'm planning to make individual videos about the stages in this project because it's too much for one episode. So it will be one episode about the Z80, one episode about the block RAM and how I initialized the block RAM. I had to write some Python script there. Then the video controller and the keyboard attachment. The keyboard is actually a very, very interesting code, and it's nice to be dissected a little bit because it's very well written. So I'll show you a little bit of this computer, and you let me know in the comments if you want me to proceed in explaining more about this implementation. I hope you enjoy. Okay, so this is my so-called Spectrum. I'm just going to try to grab the keyboard and type something. So I'll change the background of the screen, which I think I have to go in some weird mode here. paper, I think it's paper, ink. Okay, ink. I'll just change the color of the ink, and then I'm going to change the color of the paper. Let's make it what? Some random color, I don't know. Tweet. Ah, pinky color. Now, I wrote a tiny little basic program here, which took me a while, and I'm just going to run it. It just creates some, print some message FPGA with many colors. Hey, scroll. Yes, yeah, scroll. Now I want to continue. Yeah, so it's just scrolling with some random colors. Now, if I wanted to, let's say I want to change the message. How do I do that? I break here. Sorry. The one problem is that it's very, very fast. So even when you type, it's kind of challenging because you kind of get repeat characters. Let's change the print. So 10 print, I think it's like that. Let's say Z80 65 megahertz MHZ Sinclair. Okay. Let's run this fellow. Hey, what a beautiful message we got, right? So this is a fully operational basic machine right now with a stupid keyboard, obviously. What do I want? I want to change the paper 0. Yeah, so we can see something. Yeah, so this is it. So I'm going to restart, basically reset the whole board. So you will see the initial screen when it starts. I hope it starts. Yeah. It didn't reset. I'm not sure why it didn't reset. Yeah, it didn't reset. Now, I'll reprogram from the tools here, the FPGA, so that will reset. We like it or not. So, program device, program. So now it's reprogramming the FPGA, so it should. Yay, that's the start screen, right? Exactly like a Spectrum. And we go like this, and we can type. Obviously, we lost everything there. We can type 10, print, what do we want to print? GGGGG, and 20, go to 10. A very clever program, right? And run. Bang! Very, very nice. So, guys, this is it. It's not much. I mean, it doesn't look like much. And I hope you enjoyed, and I'll try to make those episodes to dissect the whole thing.